Hello, how are you doing?
How are you doing?
Nice to talk to you. So tell me about your role in this.
I just play one of the G-men that are sort of going after the bad guys, but probably people will think that those bad guys are good guys.
Exactly. We're going to be cheering for the good guys. That's horrible.
No,
you go. We're cheering for the bad guys.
For the bad guys, yeah. Johnny Depp's very good looking, and you probably want to cheer for him anyway. So.
Well, and did you read the book that this is based on?
I did not. No.
I was amazed when I read it how inept the guys were when they first started out. Is that portrayed in the film?
You mean the FBI?
Yeah.
Yes. Yes, you're correct. They were under gun. They didn't have the gun power that the other guys had. They were always kind of one step behind. If you're a criminal, your mind is thinking in a way that you're always thinking about how not to get caught, where these guys are trying to catch you. But, when that was developed, before that, people could go interstate and just split. And that's why they created this government brand of this sort of, this unit to go after these guys. But even, these guys were sort of, they brought them out of Yale and Harvard, and, they were bright guys, but they didn't know, you gotta catch a criminal, you gotta think like a criminal.
Exactly.
And they weren't those guys.
So
they fell a little short.
Yeah. But it's like 70 years later, and we're still fascinated with that time period. Why is that?
Well, I think, it's a romantic period. I think that the economy was bad like it is today. I think that, it's sort of a Robin Hood thing. And I think, people today would admire somebody who was doing that because they think they're getting screwed over by the government.
Exactly.
So I think that's why people have a fascination for it. And it's a romantic kind of, a time in history where things were simpler. Now it's a lot harder to break into a bank.
Exactly. Michael Mann is a director. Amazing.
The guy is a phenomenal filmmaker. He's attention to detail and his the way that he sort of it's. I've worked with different filmmakers, some good, some okay, and I've never seen anybody dedicated the way that he's dedicated. It's like his life depends upon it, and it's pretty neat to see. He'll change an extra's tie in the background to make sure that his film is the way he wants it to be.
And you guys actually shot in the actual locations where a lot of this went on.
Yeah.
What's that like for you guys as actors to actually be in that spot?
It's terrific. I mean, you're getting paid to shoot Tommy guns and to drive 1930s cars, and who wouldn't want to do that? I mean, it's great. And it's great for the communities that we shot in as well. I mean, it brought a huge amount of revenue to the towns we were in. So it's kind of a kickback for them, and it's fun for them. And when you film, Johnny Depp is like Princess Diana. There's like 4,000 people lined up to see this guy, and he would meticulously go down the row and sign everybody's autograph, and he was a real trooper in that. And it was kind of amazing, to see that after a 12, 14 hour day, he would do that. And they'd wait in the hail with their babies. It's like the baby doesn't care about anything.
That's the best story, though. We never hear good stuff about actors anymore.
Yeah.
It's nice to hear something good on the set. Thank you so much, sir. Appreciate it. Thank you.